we're out and about. It's relatively nice. If the wind doesn't blow, it's not so bad. It's like 55 or so, but it's supposed to be back in the 60s. This week, I'm actually gonna try to get some, I love doing the little driving montages sometimes for like 30 seconds or something, not very long. You have to record like 2 or 4 minutes depending how much you speed it up. But I brought the tripod. And gosh, Brian's had this big old thing forever and a day. I'm actually gonna set it up in the car and just see if we can get some shots from the back seat maybe. I'm actually going lamp shopping today. Those two black tables I told you about that I got for my room, for my bedroom, I'm trying to get white lamps similar to the Sex and the City picture. I know I'm not gonna get exactly, but some kind of nice white lamp would be great for the room and not spend a lot of money on it because that's what we're gonna do.
Here we go. We're going up.
Lower, please. level.
That really loud beep. Hate it. This one doesn't have a double tag.
Up your chef.
Otis, hey. Terry, I found Otis. We're at Huxley's warehouse and there's just, not happy. I really don't like this place because there's always some questionable people in here. And it's kind of an outlet, so you don't always get the best deals on, or you get good deals, but not always the best looking furniture, so it's kind of pick and choose. Hanging out with this one. You may have to go to the bathroom, but I got cups. And it, look here, here's the up and down, here's the light, and then this is a USB port. I mean, what more could you want, you know?
Well, that place was a bust. I was really actually kind of hoping that, I was actually kind of like a sort of, kind of hoping that I would find something at that place, but I guess it wasn't meant to be. I don't know, I feel like $150 for a lamp is a little too much. Maybe I'm just...
Yes.
Is this a one-way? No. Maybe I'm just cheap or something. But
frugal.
I'm frugal. I am. But I always find a good deal. I mean, I vey marry well.
I know
that. I love vey marry well. She was fantastic in those Fred Astaire movies. Oh. Can I talk without you trying to jump in? Motherfucker. I'm so tired of him.
See
already.
How nasty he is all the time.
I'm trying to talk. If I interrupt done. You, I'm you done. Go off. Okay. Shut up. Anyway. I don't know where we're going to go next. Maybe we'll find a thrift store or something. I know what I want. I'm flexible on the somewhat on the style, but I kind of want it to be a white lamp. That's important. Or I saw a silver, like, mirrored one. Are you in the bike lane or are you in the regular lane?
Why don't you just talk since that's what you're so...
Well, I may have to drive too. I don't know. Going under a bridge. Hold your breath. Okay, it's supposed to be for good luck. All right, cell phone footage because I don't want to reach down and get the camera out of there. But we just went to a little thrift store we had forgotten about. That we were at years and years ago, and it's still there. And I found a white lamp for $20. And I said, you know, you can take the shade off and keep it, resell it. I don't want it because it was dirty and gross. Goodbye. Supported a local business, which I always feel good about. I always like doing that. Well, we're in the old neighborhood where I first lived when I moved here. It's so different now. These used to have all businesses in them. I don't know what's in it now, but this place here that's still a chiropractor. It's actually 109 Green. That 111 is an apartment upstairs. But this was our office. This was our old street, Westerlo Street, where this was my first real apartment. And actually, this row of brownstones here used to be a lot prettier and brighter, and that was always in the Apartment Guide magazine. This was our old place, 73. This was my first apartment upstairs, actually. And that's where Brian moved in when we started shacking up. When we were lovers. Mm. But that was it. And it was great because we had parking right here. The thing is, this is South Pearl Street. On this end, where we lived, wasn't so bad. But when you cross it and go up the hill there, it really, really got ghetto. When I moved down here and they gave me this apartment. I almost changed apartments. I was going to move into this one bedroom, which I'm glad I didn't because Brian had too much shit. And the DMV is only one block over. So whenever we had to renew a license or something, we could literally just walk out the door and go one block over. So, you know, it's kind of, some of it's run down, some of it's kind of ghetto, some of it's not. But this was the old hood back in the day, and it was nice back then. There was a rejuvenation thing going on with downtown, so it was really nice. But these days, not so much. We just passed a shop, and Brian's like, it's funny how you pass that smoke shop and you smell marijuana. And I kept smelling something, because marijuana kind of has that pungent, kind of skunky smell, but not like bad skunk. So you can definitely...
Well, there's no such thing as good skunk.
No, but like if you smell pot, it's at least tolerable, so. Well, as Karen would say, we're taking the long way home, but as Mike would say, this is how they always go home. We're heading to Target now. I'm actually going to get a shade for this lamp that I got and maybe see if they have another lamp there. If not, at least I got one. Just want to go home and take a nap.
Jammies.
Not even jammies. Just like, I just want to go take a nap real quick.
Skip dinner.
You know what it is? In the summertime, you're so used to going out and you tend to have a little... I think people have a little bit more stamina in the summertime because you're out more doing stuff. And, yeah. You know, you're so... But in the winter, you so rarely go out. And then when you do, you're just tired after an hour. You're cranky. You want to go home.
It's like half and half today. It's light out and nice, but it's still cold.
Yeah. Yeah, because the wind's kicking up, but, so yeah, I'm, you know, my feet are hurting, and, I just want to go home. We're going to run into Target, though, and do that, and then we'll be home.
No running.
I haven't run in years.
Crawling.
I've had the runs, but I haven't run in years.
It's a whole nother story.
It is. Successful. This is the one lamp I bought, and I got a nice kind of simple shade for it, and then I just went ahead and bought this other one from Target because I kind of liked it, and it added a little bit more personality to the room, and it's kind of got this really cool texture on the glass, and I've always kind of liked these lamps with the balls in them like that. So all in all, I spent $100. I'm recording vinyl. I told you I was going to be working on it. I actually made a phone call to a radio show for Caliwood, who I did the reel for that we were talking about, that I've been working on all week. And she was talking about it today on her radio show. But I got to clean up a little bit here. Brian and I are tired. Brian got a network extender. Sometimes we have a little bit of problem in the living room. I don't necessarily on my Mac, but... on the TV and things like that, it gets to be a little bit weird. We're just going to veg out for the afternoon. There's actually a radio show going on right now that my friends are doing. Because it's almost 6:30, so I might call in there and say, hey. But other than that, I hope your Saturday is going good. Mine has been successful. Not quite what I planned on with this other lamp, but I like it. Other than that, I'm happy. I got what I wanted. I'm broke, but I can see. So I ain't got no clothes on. Well, I have socks on. Wait a minute. Okay, now I don't have any clothes on. Just spent the evening recording vinyl and had a little ice cream. Talked to some friends on the radio. Talked about Bruce Jenner. Remember that I did a commentary video a few weeks ago on Bruce Jenner. So if you go look for the playlist What Drives Ernest Up the Wall, you will find a commentary. It may be... the second most recent one in that playlist. There's something on there about Bruce Jenner. I'll probably talk again about that interview. I just wanted to give people time to see it before I really said anything about it. Everybody's got their opinions, but I have mine. So I may do another... it doesn't really drive me up. Well, there is something about it that drives me up the wall, but you'll just have to watch to find out. Brian's just poking around on his computer. He was watching a bunch of old TV crap earlier. So we will see you Sunday. We'll probably pop out on Sunday and we will see you then. So thank you for watching and stay tuned. There's some more right after this. I hate these lamps. those lamps are nice. That second lamp that I got that's glass or whatever is nice, but it's just not working for the room. Because I need two tall white lamps, one on either side. And I don't have that. It doesn't look right. It's bugging me. So I think I'm going to take that lamp and shade back. And I have another white lamp there on the end table. I think I'm just going to buy the shade for it and use that over there. So it's two white lamps. They're different, but they have the same shade. Hope your Sunday's going good. We'll see you out and about.
Hello.
Oh, wow. Look who colored his hair.
You know, you got a blab.
Well, it's noticeable because you're not a silver fox anymore.
I've never been a silver fox.
That's true.
Like top of my
head. It's more like a hedgehog.
Yeah, pretty much.
So, as I noted a bit ago, I really didn't like that lamp. Went back to Target, returned the lamps, turn around, boom. There it is.
Boom.
I found what I needed, and that was good. So that saves us a trip, but we're out. It's like 12:40 now. We've only been up for a couple hours, but we are starving. We've only had some coffee today, so we're kind of just venturing up Route 9, for those of you that know, and we're just trying to find some food. Brian probably wants breakfast, but for me, it doesn't necessarily matter, as long as it's something good.
Look, if I find a bagel line on the side of the road, I'm eating it.
I really want some pho, but if we don't make it that far, I'm kind of happy with whatever. So, man, I'm all about that pho. Because I'm all about that pho. About that pho. No, Raymond. Ah! We just came from this diner, but they sat this woman. There were like three tables next to each other. Brian and I were at one end, and then they sat this woman with this guy who looked a little haggard, the guy did, over next to us. And as soon as she sat down, she's like, you know, the waitress is like, hi, how are you today? Well, I feel like I'm eating with 10,000 people. Have you ever eaten with 10,000 people, bitch? And the waitress is like, yeah, we're busy on Sunday. I'll be back in a minute. So they're looking through. They come back. It's like, are you guys ready to order drinks yet? No. And like from the minute they got in there, this woman was like being a bitch. Just in general, to the guy she was with and to everything else. So they're going over the menu. And the poor guy, I don't know if it was her son or her husband, but he was just like, she was just beating him down, and then they're going through the menu. It's like, well, why would a Reuben be open-faced? I guess you'll have to close it. She didn't want, like, the ketchup and the hot sauce and the jelly and the salt and pepper, so she's, like, putting it on the end. She's like, you know, and just, like, banging it on the other table, putting it away from it because she can't be bothered. So they make their order. It takes them a few minutes to order. Well, then they get their food, and she's telling the guy, well, you're not eating that with a knife. It's an open-faced Reuben, bitch, and that's why it comes with a knife.
I had the Reuben, and it was relatively easy to close up, actually. I used the knife and just creased it in half. And she said at one point that she was angry. Can we just eat? And I'm like, you look like you've been sitting up eating, like the rest of us, but still. You know, Brian and I were just talking about it, and I said, what is it with people when you have, like, an issue and you have some drama, you know, don't visit that on people that are just trying to do their job, especially like wait staff or something like that, which, you know, wait staff, what does wait staff make? Like $2.50 an hour or $2.25? Because they live on tips, you know, tips are everything. And so they're, you know, and you're not always guaranteed that someone's going to be nice to you and leave you a tip. These people are just trying to do their job. You can be angry and have your drama, but don't visit it on somebody else. Just flip your switch while you're in there and calm the fuck down for a minute. We're sitting there just amazed because every time this woman would open her mouth, she just...
Venom.
It was piss and vinegar, you know? It was. It was vitriol coming out. Oh, and then we're driving because Brian's like, let's see what's up this way. So we're driving up the road. And I look over, and there's this little girl that's probably like 6 or 7 years old sitting out at the edge of her driveway with a table in front of her. And I said, turn the car around. Brian's like, no. And I'm like, no, turn the car around. That woman or that little girl is selling Girl Scout cookies. And so I made Brian turn the car around, and we went over there. And he's like, you know, because he doesn't want to do it. Well, I get out, and I get it. I just had a five on me because who carries cash, right? And so I got a box of Thin Mints. Well, Brian only has a 20, so of course...
Right, and they don't have change, so I said, I'll just blow the 20.
So there's six boxes. Look at Brian. Brian colored his hair.
Those luscious brown locks of hair.
Here.
What are you doing? Did he just serve shade?
Hi there. We're in my room earlier, and first she was mad because I was in the chair, because she always wants to be in my chair, and then I moved over a little bit, and she hopped next to me and curled up to me there, and then we came in here, and here she is again.
And there she is again.
And there she is again.
I'm not always this beautiful. Just kidding. Oh, we just finished a really good dinner. I happen to have made it this time, but Brian makes good dinners too. But we had this pork roast that I had taken out and forgot to cook. And it didn't go bad or anything. But Brian reminded me. I'm like, well, I'll just put it in there tomorrow then. So I'm such a bad vegetarian. I'm not vegetarian lately. I put the... And it was delicious, and Brian liked it, and I liked it, and we're getting ready to watch Judge Judy. That's about it.
Brian never has a thick coffee at home.
Only some of you will get that reference. Oh, today, Monday, I mean, you're seeing this on Tuesday at least, but Monday there was a new commentary that went up, a new What Drives Ernest Up the Wall. I put it up today, so go check that out. Give it a thumbs up when you get to the end of it, and click subscribe. You can give it a thumbs up over here on your right. Just give it a thumbs up. Let us know you made it to the end of this video. Over here on your left, the big red button, subscribe. If you're new to YouTube and you're one of those people that have never been on YouTube, welcome. Hit subscribe for updates. We upload new vlogs every Tuesday and Friday, a new commentary every other Monday, and a new challenge video every other Sunday. And I didn't think I had any other challenge videos. I was going to have to do some. There is another one with Cheryl, but I have a couple of ideas which you're going to be a part of. So we'll have to do that soon. But anyway, that's it for us. Everybody have a great week, and I'm expecting my rug tomorrow. So that'll be in Friday's vlog. The room is slowly coming together. I forgot that whole lamp fiasco figured out.
At least you can see your floor. Mine's still kind of covered.
Yeah, and I got to pull up that rug that's in there tonight because I got to make room for the other one. So thank you for watching, and you're awesome. We might be more awesome. I don't know. No.
No, you're more awesome. Not you. Yeah.
Oh.
Mm. I think I will have another cup of coffee.
Jim never has a second cup of coffee at home.
Called in life to know what you want and what you don't want. What you're willing to stand for and what you're willing to say, no, boo-boo, you gotta go. Of course, I also understand that when it comes to family and really close friends, if one of those people happened to be a